Commander. So, hey, what do you think if you were going to tell somebody in the public, you know, this is what we did and it really helped us to be safe and get rescued? What was the...
We were calm. We realized stuff was going wrong. Everybody did their thing. Rocky was getting life jackets and rope. Mark was calling in Mayday. Me and Bobby were getting stuff together. I grabbed a couple of Gatorades, put in my pocket, just in case, you know, you don't have how long. We real level-headed, took our time, got off, and
nobody freaks out whatsoever.
That was it. Just got to be calm.
And, I mean, us being, if we weren't so close to that rig, we'd definitely, we'd probably still be in the ocean holding onto the boat as long as it took until the Coast Guard would have gotten there. But we were just so lucky we were right near that rig and in, like, perfect position for the wind and the current to take us right to where we needed to be.
You know, we were about 23 or 24 miles offshore, so we weren't close to land at all. And when we made the Mayday call, the Coast Guard was actually on the scene within 25 minutes. I mean, we had a helicopter that came all the way from Houston, which is a long way from here. We had two Coast Guard boats. I can tell you that you know, I was very impressed with everything they did. I mean, they were all professional. They were very nice people. And, you know, I guess I really don't mind sending my check to the IRS as much now as it used to bother me.
So I guess that's it. I mean, anything you want to add just about the whole experience? Anything you would... If somebody out in the community had a question, you know, and you want to answer about how it all went down, what would it be?
Question.
Thanks, yeah. Coast Guard.
Yeah, that's what I want the public to know. The Coast Guard did a great job. Couldn't ask for a better job.
We appreciate it.
All right, well, I appreciate that, guys.
Oh, no problem. Thank you.
I'm glad to have y'all back.
Yes, oh, thank you, so that's
it. Appreciate it. For, so basically what happened?
Basically what happened, we got a call. It was a boat 22 miles offshore taking on water. So got a crew together, headed out in the 25. 41 went out as well. Had to dewater, pump a little bit better stuff on board to deal with it, but took a little longer for it to get out there. We arrived on scene about the same time as the helicopter from Secretary Houston Galveston. Made it on scene, found no signs of the vessel, found the crew up standing on the platform of an oil rig. We checked them for medical injuries. There wasn't any, so we got them off, transferred them over to the 41 when they got on scene, then went and checked the vessel, see if maybe it could be righted or not, and pick up all the debris around it.
So,
back in.
What were the conditions like out there?
Conditions, seas were probably 3 to 5 feet. Real sloppy, real choppy. Winds coming out of the east, southeast, so kind of an offshore set. So, running out there wasn't too bad. Got airborne a bunch, but coming back in was a different story. It was bumpy. All
right. And so, what do you think the best thing that these guys did to get themselves out of harm's way? What do you think the best thing they did?
The best thing they did before the boat completely went under was get over on that rig. If a rig wouldn't have been around, the best thing they should have done was, after they made sure the PFDs were on and everything, make sure they should have stayed with the hull of the boat. But they were close enough to the rig, they could just go straight to it.